There may be no muscle more important to the biomechanical functioning of the human body than the psoas. Yet it is also one of the least understood and poorly trained muscles, in large part because it's located so deeply inside the core that it cannot be observed from the outside. In fact, many people don't even know it exists. However, understanding the psoas's function and training it properly will do more to keep you biomechanically sound and injury-free than training any other single muscle in the human body. So over the next 5 minutes, we will demystify what the psoas is, what it does, and how you can alter your training to always maintain good psoas hygiene. The psoas is found deep within the core, starting near the top of the lumbar spine and moving down over the pelvis, attaching to the inner portion of the femur. On a well-defined, muscular body, you can find the location of the psoas's origin by finding the very bottom of the lower traps. This is the spot on the spine where the psoas begins. Its simplest function, and the one it's best known for, is its ability to strongly flex the hip. You can understand how it does this by imagining that the psoas is an arm of the spine which reaches out over the pelvis to grab the inner thigh. When you flex the hip, it's as if the arm is doing a reverse curl with the leg bone, pulling it up towards the spine and rotating it to the outside. Other muscles also play a part in flexing the hip, such as the rectus femoris, sartorius, and others, at least until about 90 degrees of hip flexion. Past 90 degrees, the only muscles that can continue to flex the hip are the psoas and its sister muscle, the iliacus. These two muscles share a tendon on the thigh, and together are often referred to as the iliopsoas muscle group. The psoas is something of a keystone muscle in the body, and when dysfunctional, it will cause systemic compensations that spread that dysfunction to the core, legs, and often the entire body. Common symptoms of psoas problems are popping or painful hips, lumbar pain, SI joint pain, or general stiffness in the low back and hips. However, the question of how it alters the skeletal structure has been a subject of confusion for many people. You see, a tight psoas is often blamed or implicated in the common anterior pelvic tilt, and yet also implicated in the posterior pelvic tilt, even though they are opposite postural movements. The confusion stems from the fact that most people believe the psoas is only a hip flexor. And while it's true the psoas is a primary hip flexor, it's also been discovered that the psoas actually has two distinct sets of fibers, the deep and superficial, each attaching to different structures on the vertebrae, which ever so slightly changes their angle of pull. The result is that the superficial fibers cause flexion of the lumbar spine and hips, while the deep fibers are actually capable of extending the spine when they are contracted. Adding to this complexity is the fact that while many people have tight, chronically contracted psoas muscles, it's just as common to see a weak and overly elongated psoas, or even a tight or weak iliacus muscle, all of which can cause different variations of these same common postural dysfunctions. And just to make your head spin a little more, it's also fairly typical to have one psoas that is overly tight and another that is weak and elongated, often leading to hip hike or even functional scoliosis, both of which can wreak havoc on the low back and hips and make it seem impossible to train pain-free. The takeaway here is that psoas dysfunction is common, and it can be a complicated issue. So let's dial things back and take a look at what the psoas is supposed to do in a naturally healthy body. First, it's important to realize that while hip flexion is one of the most powerful functions of the psoas, it's not actually its primary function. You see, while humans do spend some time in active hip flexion on a regular basis, they spend much more time standing and walking, and the psoas is very active in both of these circumstances. During standing, the psoas stabilizes the lower spine, helping to maintain the natural curve of the lower back. And while walking, it's actually the psoas that initiates each step and maintains the rhythm of walking, like a pendulum, moving back and forth. These small movements in the core become greater movements in the extremities, as the large muscles of the hips and legs coordinate with the action of the psoas. If the psoas is tight, weak, or out of sync, most people will initiate walking with the rectus femoris muscle of the quads. This creates a stiffer and less graceful walking pattern that uses more energy, shuts down the spinal engine mechanism of gait mechanics, and causes more dysfunctional muscle compensations throughout the body. So, while you can analyze and discover the exact cause of your unique psoas dysfunction, for most people, it's overly complicated and unnecessary. Simply being aware of the psoas and adding functional training for it into your routine is often enough to bring the muscle back into health and greatly improve overall body biomechanics. So here are three ways true to the actual functioning of the psoas that you can add into your training. First is to learn some form of psoas release. This will help immediately address excess tension and allow for better movement. Though this is usually just a temporary measure, it will provide a lot of relief for many people with SI pain, hip popping, or lumbar pain, and it will buy you some time to implement other corrective measures to make the changes more permanent. One of the simplest ways to relax and potentially release the psoas is to focus on deep diaphragmatic breathing, as the psoas is actually fascially connected directly to the diaphragm. This direct connection allows the rhythmic movement of deep breathing to internally massage and bring blood flow to the psoas. You can also seek out a knowledgeable manual or massage therapist and have them manually release the psoas for you, or you can manually release it yourself. However, there are large arteries and nerves running through and around the psoas, and it's important not to damage them. So it's best to be safe and use a blunt object to help you release the psoas, such as a lacrosse ball or a release tool designed specifically for the psoas, such as the psoriate. Next is to strengthen and stretch the psoas. This is a pretty simple task. You simply need a go-to hip flexor stretch that you like, such as any kind of kneeling lunge stretch, and a hip flexor strengthening exercise in your routine, ideally one that brings you to or past 90 degrees of hip flexion. You can also accomplish both tasks at the same time with certain isometric stances, such as the warrior poses of yoga or the bow stance of kung fu. And finally, it's important to learn how to use the psoas correctly. Muscles don't move on their own. It is your voluntary actions that cause them to move. Many people will technically correct every muscle issue that is causing pelvic tilt and yet still stand in a pelvic tilt because they have never learned how not to. In this case, the problem will just redevelop unless new habits are learned. There are many physical traditions and ancient systems which place great importance on learning to relax the psoas by standing, moving, and breathing into a neutral pelvic and spinal posture. The mountain pose in yoga and the wuji stance in tai chi are standing poses which reinforce this habit. Tai chi also does a great job of teaching you to walk by initiating with the psoas, though you can learn this by simply taking a quiet, mindful walk and making sure you are beginning each step with the waist and not the legs, right in the center of gravity area, also known as the dantian in Chinese martial arts. Incorporating these methods into your warm-ups, training routines, or daily habits will help you keep your psoas healthy and your posture and your biomechanics problem-free. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to like and subscribe and hit the notification bell to be notified of future videos. Good luck with your training, and until next time, keep moving, my friends.